Jesus Christ, man. I think exclamation mod scopes, I think. The Dragon Eyes for Covenant, I get it because I start out in the class that has the Covenant. Like, I could just take it off. Like, we actually don't need it at all, but I don't know. Fucking settlement, dude. So annoying. As if settlement needed to be worse, dude. It's like a trillion enemies. Like, you would almost think that, like, I'm playing on, like, the challenge mode because of how many enemies there are, but, like, I'm not even playing on the challenge mode. There's just that many. Oh, dude, I forgot the weapon art. Oh, whatever. That was actually a faster fight. Not really. Like, it was pretty similar. Like, there's definitely a better way to be fighting Gundyr with this thing. I just don't know what it is. Like, I wonder if I could get a stagger in phase one and then weapon art on the stagger and just kill him. Okay, I gotta hit the firebomb throw, and then I have to not get fucked by the evangelist. I'm gonna kill the evangelist next time. Like, I was gonna do that, but I missed the dog, so. Kind of have a feeling that like 99% of the runs we're going to lose is going to be just in settlement, and then the rest is going to be just fine. Got a bad feeling, dude. See, Gundyr can get in such a bad spot when you're, like, fighting him for a longer amount of time. And this is where, like, you just can't strafe stuff because of the... Like, when you're, like, along the walls or something. We're like consistently at like 620 when we kill the last Gundyr. Which I guess is good. Space Monkey, what's up, man? I feel like I've once gotten a plus one weapon before Dancer. I don't know how. I think maybe like Gundyr dropped a Titanite Shard, or like maybe an enemy before him did. Like maybe that's possible. That was almost a bad scenario right there. I'm kind of worried that might happen. Like, the spear guy... Like, I should outspace him every time, though. Like, but maybe I could get roll caught. Too fast. That actually could have been bad if he didn't buff there. Might chase me all the way here. You know, be pretty hard, I think, would be like a no hit run on the like champions or Covenant of Champions or whatever. I actually think that would be really hard, like the enemies that are in the boss fights especially. Second time in a row we've gotten a Primordial from Dancer. Hey, it's a Pursuer. He somehow got down here. He's just not shooting like fucking lightning bolts at me. Or Or I guess like hexes. It actually, it'd like make sense if he had a hex. Alright, hopefully you don't get fucked in settlement again. Just because I'm trying to get rings that give us more damage, which is like super unnecessary, but. You know. If I could kill the dogs, that would be nice. Like, what is this, like, nerfed black firebomb range? There we go. This is 1.6, Aquarius. Welcome back, by the way. I think that's the best point to drop off on, like, just before him. Like, hitting him doesn't really do anything. I just need to, like, be able to roll into him. Uh-oh, there's a guy behind me. Of course, do you know if there's ever been a nerf to the, or, like, a change to the twin axes? Or, like, have they always been this good? I wonder, see, like, a thrall could chase me when I'm waiting here. Like, he could show up around the corner. But I, like, sort of need to wait because I need this guy to go to the way. Oh, it's nerfed in the newer version? Feels bad. Oh, they tried to throw fucking shit at me, dude. Okay, I'm still not sure what to do about this freaking part, dude. Because, like, if we want to get Flynn's ring, obviously we have to go on that island, but then that island also triggers the enemies on the bridge up here to load in, which is, like, the evangelist, right? If one does spawn. But then we've got the NPC. So hopefully we don't get in a fucking lose scenario where it's like, oh... Evangelist attacks me, and then this guy does that, and I can't see anything. Fuck off, dude. God damn it, man. It's a lot of work for a ring, man. Honestly, a run would be a lot more consistent if I just didn't even come to settlement. But. Where is he? Oh, he's right there. I'm just gonna wait a second because he sniped me when I jumped off the building. Okay. Razor, thanks for the good luck, dude. Finally. I guess we don't really need that ring yet, but let's are we plus zero right now? Yeah, I think so. I guess we'll do that. Although that doesn't seem right for some reason. Do I need to buy anything? I'm just not going to. I don't think it makes a difference anywhere. Of course, I forgot the bonfire too. So that's good. Oh, maybe I was supposed to sell the souls and then level up. Whatever. I'll do it here, actually. Like, it doesn't really cost that much to upgrade. It's really annoying actually coming to Farenkeep from this direction. Let's go to the stupid slugs. The slugs are actually like kind of scary to drop on. Okay, that's what I remember getting 1717. Okay, that's right, for sure. Let me lot Estus just in case we need to heal or something. I don't know. Poison does like 3 times the damage in this mod, so it's basically toxic, I'm pretty sure. Like, should I just drop from like this height? Oh god. Fuck. We still need one more large shard, and I don't know where to get it. Turco, what's up, man? Yeah, I don't know where to get it because I'm pretty sure there's only five large shards here. Unless one got moved. Maybe, I don't know. Fuck. Yeah, we have to drop off of this three times if we want to do reverse. Like, honestly, I should just not do reverse. I should do forward. Like, it honestly could be faster to just run back from that bonfire, too. Just because, like, coming up here, coming down the ladder, like, it takes a long time. I'm actually going to not do this anymore. I just don't know. Yeah, I'm not exactly sure what I should do. Oh, dude, why don't I just start this way? Yeah, there is a large shard there, Aquarius, but it's kind of slow to get. But yeah, that's the one I've been getting. I could just do this, go this way, get the bonfire, and then go get the last one. That makes so much more sense. And then I could just run back from there, even if I don't want to jump off from the ladder. Yeah, that's so much better. Okay, we'll do that next time. This guy's really scary with this slow of a weapon. Oh god, dude, I did not mean to do that L1. That was just like instinct right there. I should be swinging with the R1s, dude. Alright, that's actually gonna be a lot faster too, so that's good. This guy's aggro range isn't increased. You'll see, Turco. You'll see, dude. Don't even worry about it. So I might as well just do this. Yeah, I think it is outdated. Like, I was looking around for the Titanite chart or the large chart behind, like, the third flame, and there's none there. I think it got replaced by rusted coins or whatever. Yeah, I was like looking. Which honestly, I feel like it probably should be there, just because it makes sense to have. I don't know. I guess there is six still. We gotta be fast so we don't die. I love so much that Storytellers is not a... Well, I guess it's not Storytellers, but... How we can pick up that... Like, weapon art... Without having to farm it. It's great. That's gonna be so nice on all bosses. I should just went back to the last bonfire. Oh shit, yeah. Fuck. Yeah, see, it would just be a lot smoother if I could just get a large shard. like somewhere in Farenkeep before opening the door. I guess it's not a huge deal though. It just it does waste some time on this run, but like obviously I'm not gonna change it for a no hit run. Don't kill me. Okay. I'm excited to go do the new route through here. That's gonna be so much better. So much safer too. And there's literally no reason to not do it that way. Dragon Eyes? It's for a covenant. It's for Hawkwood Covenant. And I'm getting them because I have the like just my starting class. Starts with the covenant equip, so I'm like I just keep it on. Okay, so our damage on Watcher is actually really bad, and it's because we're using Dark. But I think it would be slower to go get Fire at this point, and I really think starting with the branch is better, so. It's just safer. It's just so much safer, like. Yeah. Yeah, so basically, whenever I have a Covenant equipped, like, each enemy has, like, a chance to drop, like, a Covenant item. So it's not, like, shitty to get Covenants. It's actually, like, the Covenants in this mod is, like, it's, like, legit. It's really fucking cool, actually. Like, the Covenants in the base game are just so shitty. Like, there's nobody likes them. Like, they don't feel that rewarding. Like, you don't even know what you're getting. And this is cool because it's like a shop menu, right? So each thing costs a certain amount of, you know, in this case, it's the Dragon Eyes. Each item costs, like, a certain amount. So you can actually, like, see what you're getting. Why are you going after me, dude? That is... Oh my god, that's ridiculous, man. Well, here we go. Right there. Come on. No! You idiot, dude. This fight is painful in this mod. Like, even more so than just normal. And I think it's because... the clones have so much more HP, which is probably like it's to balance out, right? Like, because technically you can do Watchers as like the last Cinder, right? Okay, actually, we got good RNG here though. I mean, it'll be better when the backstab damage is buffed up again in like the newer version, but I'm not updating yet, so that was actually pretty good. Good RNG. But yeah, it's to balance it, like, you can come back here with, like, fucking plus 15 if you really wanted to. I like the phase 2, though. I like, you know, I definitely think phase 2 should have more HP. That's nice. Like, what I think that, like, Watchers should have been in, like, the base game is phase 1 have, like, a lot less HP. Like, half. And then, like, just make it so that you get the good part of the fight more often, you know? Raiden, yeah, dude. Yeah. Oh, damn it. not a spell bug? Oh, like going through the walls? Is that what you mean? Like of that one NPC? Or is that not what you're talking about? I'm just gonna go get the fire gem right now. Actually, no, I won't. It's fine. We don't need it yet. Next, what's up, dude? Yeah, that was pretty funny. Yeah. Trying to fight that dude. Alright, so we're gonna get 5 dark buffs. I'm gonna sell, I guess I could sell those, but sell that. We're gonna get, I think, to +7. So we're +5. Get that. Oh, I short. That's weird. Am I short? Okay, well, +6 it is then, I guess. Did I, like, forget to sell something? Whatever, not a big deal. We gotta go to shrine, actually. You don't have to, Tiger. Like, if you want to, sure, but, like, I kind of, like, test myself, too. So, I don't know. I mean, we could both test stuff. Although, like, it's actually really hard to choose, like, a version to be on. Like, because, like, ideally you would have one. I don't know how I'm so short on souls right now. Like, one other run, I was able to buy, like, 6 large shards. Or 6 chunks. Or, like, 4 chunks or something. I really forgot to do something. Yeah, it's really hard when something's being, like, constantly updated to, like, pick a version to be on. Right? But, like, as of right now, I'm definitely doing this run on this version. And I was, like, planning on doing all boss on it, too. Just because, like, realistically, like, critical damage doesn't really do anything. Especially, like, it's still normal on, like, certain bosses, I found. Like, on Pontiff, it's normal. As far as I can tell, at least. And that's really the only place in the run where I'd do a crit. Like, so it seems normal on the bosses, so it's like, just like the NPCs, which don't matter, obviously. Sigma Duck, what's up, dude? I'm not sure, Raiden. Not sure. Like, I think the thing is, you just don't want it to be, like, too broken. Like, this is kind of pushing the limits already using this weapon, I feel like. Okay, we want to buy. Oh, shit, I didn't know that. Oh, okay, that's annoying. Okay, well. I didn't know that was going to happen. Like, so we lose our ability to access chunks if we use a memory. What? The goddamn carpet, dude. Let me just make sure there's no, like, guys right outside. Definitely cannot go for greed hits with this weapon on that fight. We need, like, a carpet removal mod or something. Get that goddamn carpet out of here. Okay, well, I might as well... Right? I might as well do that. It's probably more effective than... leveling up my character. Okay, we're probably gonna do big damage here, hopefully. Yeah, because before I was, like, leveling up my character in between fights. Oh, yeah. That's pretty good. Did I miss that? Oh yeah, like I definitely do not mind fighting six dancers because yeah, dancers pretty fun. It's not like you're fighting like four Rons, you know? Plus Ron's a longer fight. Yeah, the reason we fight so many Whoops. Gotta buy another one then. That was dumb. The reason we fight so many dancers is because we want to get the cat ring, and we also want, We want enough souls to level up to +9, basically. And, like, we might as well, right? Like, it doesn't take much time. And we're just getting way stronger, so... Oh my god, I can't buy... Ugh. Okay. That's a bit annoying. Come on, dancer. I actually really like the first L1 of the Twin Axes, but then I hate the follow-ups. They're so bad. Like, all of the rest of the follow-ups just hit the ground. Like, you never get to the first L1. It's kind of annoying. All right, one more. I kind of think in all bosses, we might end up fighting, like, 10 dancers. I don't know. Because we're definitely gonna want plus 15, right? In like all bosses, I imagine. Like, I'm sure we could do without, of course, but. Oh, I hate that. Wait, how many times do we have to fight another dancer? We need... How many is it? 20? I think we need 20 extra Primordial Titanites for... plus 14, right? It goes 2, 4, 6, 8. Right, and if we get 3 per, so that's 7 more fights. Assuming we don't get a drop anywhere else. So, I guess we're gonna be fighting, like, 14... Like, I don't know, 13 minimum dancers. Yeah. Unless we get some other drop somewhere. Bitslinger, what's up, dude? I mean, it's not bad. Look how rich we are right now. So, we're gonna go get some useful rings. The first one being Calamity. Second one being Cat Ring. Yeah, and I have an extra one just because, like, we got a drop somewhere along the way. I think from the first dancer we got one. Yeah. Yeah, 13 dancers, yeah. Imagine, like, we're going to get to such a high level on that run, though. It's going to be kind of cool. All right, I'm going to get some bundles and some resins. We're plus 9 already. So we're gonna get to 20, and then I think it's best to just go into strength at this point. We have good endurance. Like, we really, honestly, we do not even need endurance with this weapon. Which is hilarious. It depends if I update Ryan, because apparently they're nerfed. And if I don't update, like, yeah, I think I'm gonna stick with twin axes. But if I do, I'm not sure. Okay, so what we're gonna do here is get our fire gem. Yeah, twin axes seem to be the best weapon. Like, I only tested a few. And, you know, maybe there's some other weapons that turn out to be better. I'm sure there are. Like, I'm sure there are some, but... Honestly, I don't even need anything better. Like, this is already huge overkill. All right, there's our fire. Like, us not getting this run will, like, not, it won't be the result of, like, not enough damage. It will be, like, enemy placements, most likely. Like, how this bone wheel is in the middle of the hallway. He actually could chase me here. Okay, I think we're good. Like, stuff like that is what's gonna, like, prevent us from getting runs. And this is pretty poor. So, see, how have you been, man? I should put Cat Ring on for that stuff. Ring of Calamity is very big. Like, look at that AR difference, dude. It's quite nice. It's like, it's really cool too, because it's just like, I mean, I guess you could stack it with RTSR, but there's just not really a reason to, you know? Elden Ring? How strong is the Elden Ring? Is the Elden Ring, like, really good? Oh, damn, Toasty. That's crazy. Hopefully that gets better. 20%. Well, so the thing with physical is, like, I mean, I think it would be actually better. Like, if we had easy access to all the rings, like, it would probably be better to not go with Fire Infusion. Right? Because, like, a lot of the rings are physical damage, like Flynn's Ring. I missed a blade there, which is not good. Like, so it would actually probably be better to go with a different infusion, like the Enchanted Infusion, probably. But, Nicholas, what's up, dude? Well, I just don't need to update, right? I think it did actually get nerfed. Oh, hives, yeah. But it's usually triggered by something though, right? But that's I don't know. My sister used to get hives all the time though. I'm a little bit worried about this guy up here, man. I don't like this guy. Wonder if I could storytellers staff him. Yeah, Toasty, there's like a whole bunch of like rebalancing. There's a whole bunch of new weapons, rings. Progression's different, actually. Or it can be. Alright, here we go. Hopefully I'm two-handing. That's kind of like the exact move that I'm really scared of. Well, I'm scared of the trail, obviously, but... That seemed just fine. Not really sure what the hitbox is like on that attack, honestly. Zero, thanks for the good luck, man. How are you? Kazooie girl? What's up? How are you? With curse, what does that do, Aquarius? If you are about to say that it like this the weapon art inflicts curse also, if I do that, I'm gonna lose my shit, dude. No way. No way, dude. I'm calling the police, right? Like, so, if I put poison on it as well, storyteller, well, I have the longstaff. Like, that's what I'm using for the weapon art. Like, so you mean the weapon art, right? Like, you don't mean just the normal attacks? Like, the poison spore weapon art gets curse on it. Okay, we gotta do that. If that's true, we have to. Because, so what would be better then? Curse or poison? Because poison, you should be able to inflict poison and the storyteller's poison at the same time, right? That is possible. In the, like, normally. Curse is best. Okay, okay. Oh my god, we're doing that. That's so cool. That's really cool, actually. Oh my god, that's cool. Kazooie, thanks for the good luck.
Maybe I'll give you the best nut ever.
I'll permit you in a second, Aquarius.
This is going too far.
For the horde.
How cool is that, man? Thanks for the 10 months, dude. I can't get over that name change, man. Okay. I should have just gotten you to post it, and then even if you get purged, I can still see it. Oh my god, okay. This... Did that get nerfed, or... Okay, let me just show you guys this. I watched the first 3 seconds,
maybe,
I see...
I'll give you the best nut ever.
Dude, look... Oh my fucking god. Look at the HP go down. That is so funny. Well, we know what we're doing, man. Okay, that's the kind of like OP thing that like should not be in this. Like, imagine just killing Gale with that shit, dude. Like, just insta-kill. We don't die. Slab. Drop a slab. Oh. Oh, and now we lose the run because running the Sage is just a nightmare. Is there any other way to get patches? Like, you can't get patches anymore from... I guess because we're not killing Deacons, right? I don't have a curse gem, do I? Like, does that mean I could bleed with that thing? Like, have you tried bleed, Aquarius? Like, that works? Because I know there's some curse gems early, but I just didn't get them. Don't chase me that far. Fuck. This is just a total mess, dude. This is bad. Hey. I'm scared he's gonna like kick me there or something. God, this part is just so annoying. It's so scary, dude. I need to like work out a better way to get through than what I'm doing. Yeah, I'm sure it does, Miklos. Yeah, I just like, I don't even go to Cathedral at all, but maybe. Well, I guess like there's no point in even going to Cathedral because like we're killing Dancer, or we obviously would have to kill Sage anyways, right? Like it would be just nice to avoid that running section somehow. Like maybe coming from the other way. I don't know. Okay, let's continue. Wait, so it's fixed in my version now? I'm still gonna infuse. Why the hell not? What do? Yeah, I'm just gonna do it. Like, I don't think it'll matter. This part's like mildly scary, I would say. I really don't like how he, like, forces me on the left side of him. Like, I'd much prefer to be on the right side. Because you see his follow-through? Like, I feel like that's so close, man. I don't even know if I can get an R1 off here. I'm just not going to. It's honestly so unnecessary. Lorpa, welcome back, dude. And Robot, welcome back as well, dude. Yeah, like that little part is hard. Like, it's one of the hardest parts to get consistent to for normal no-hit runs, and then. Yeah. Throw in an Outrider up there. Recipe for a disaster. I hate when that guy doesn't drop down. That was really close. This part's so much fun on this. got like literally 1,000 knights shooting at me here. Good thing these aren't DS1 arrows that like, well, actually this is probably easier if it was, but just track me. I think there's more than 2x the amount of knights here. Pretty sure. Okay, I'm not gonna forget about this. Oh, you know what? Like, if this did bleed, this actually might not work for the AI cheeses. I just thought about that. Yeah, hopefully it doesn't work. Because, like, bleed, I believe, staggers. I could be wrong. And that breaks the AI cheeses for NPCs. They get staggered. He shouldn't chase me. Oh my god, it doesn't work anymore. Oh, it does. Okay, it just takes way longer. That's interesting. I wonder if it's going to do less damage now. So the poison helps with the buildup, apparently. RIP, I guess. It looks like it'll still do the same amount. Maybe it'll last longer now. We're gonna get a poison gem. Or like, I guess, what is it? Like, what do I need? A shriving stone? Hmm. If he wasn't facing this way, I could just go and hit him, but... Priscilla, welcome back. There's literally, like, there's no reason to wait for that move, either. There's actually none. Or, like, wait for a move. Like, I could just go in on anything, really. It's, like, three hits. Okay, what infusion do I need to... or what gem, or whatever... We're gonna get a Shriving Stone. Or I wonder if poison would, like, make the build-up be faster. Probably would, right? I don't know where to get that stuff, though. Oh, I do know. Oh, my God. I'm going to, actually. God damn it, the one time I don't pick it up, dude. Sirash, what's up, dude? The one time I don't pick it up because I knew it wasn't a large shard. Well, yeah, like, I think... Like, my poison buildup was way faster with the... Like, just that base. So... I guess it has something to do with that stat. Like, I don't know. All right. Aquamarine dagger not useless. I've actually never used the Aquamarine Dagger in, like, there's the base game, but yeah, magic damage is just kind of trash in the base game, but in this mod, it's, like, it's just as good as any other damage type, really, which is kind of cool, so yeah, it's probably good. Okay, what am I doing? I'm infusing. Yeah, I'm sure that'll make the build up faster. I doubt the damage will be different, but... We're still getting, like, some AR out of that, but I'm just gonna go Endurance, man. Why are you guys hurting yourselves?
Maybe I'll give you the best nut ever. This is going too far.
Alundra, thanks for the 5 months, dude. Welcome back, man. How are you? Okay, this part's actually really fucking scary. So there's an NPC here, which should be on that side. Oh, fuck you, man. Fuck you. Oh, God, that I hated that. I don't know what to do with that guy, man. Like, usually I run around the right side because it's just better. And of course he cuts me off right there. Bloodborne armors? Yeah, it does. Not sure like how many, but I know like one piece for sure. I don't really know the Bloodborne armors too well, though. Oh, is there Aquarius? Oh. Oh, interesting. Okay. That's cool. Dungeon Skip's great. It's like hardly even a skip either. It's just like, just a jump. There's almost some things that they put in to this game that like seem intentional. Like it almost seems like that's intentional. Like with that drop being almost the exact height of Cat Ring, like, or like Spook, like the limit, I guess, like lethal fall height, like it's basically, like it's very close, it's very, very close. I don't know. I hate running up that side, but I kind of have to because the NPC over there. Yeah, and it's not like an easy thing to do, right? Like, it's... like, if you... like, you would never find that on your own unless you're, like, looking for stuff, right? So, I think they add stuff like that on purpose. Like, for experienced players or speedrunners even, right? Even though speedrunners just... don't even use that, but... I'll use a buff, I guess. I should have done 3L1s there. Okay, don't let me forget the slab, you guys. Not that it like matters a whole bunch, but I would kind of like it. Yeah, the axe is pretty good. I don't think it's too broken. I think this is like kind of the maximum without being too broken. Like anything more than this would would just be, I think, a bit stupid. Like, and plus, I did have to do a lot of, like, not a lot of setup, but I had to set up for it, right? Like, I have to, fight Gundyr a few times, right, to get it at the start, and then I need to, like, right, we fight 6 dancers on this run, so, like, I should be that strong. You know? Yeah, it is quite strong, obviously. Yeah, but I'm like on a lot higher level than you'd be though right now. Like level 61. Like that's normally like the level that you would get to like Cinder at. You know? And plus like I basically have RTSR with Ring of Calamity. Like Calamity might actually be better than RTSR. I'm not 100% sure, but I don't have enough branches, you guys. It's fine. It's actually okay. Hopefully. Hopefully it's okay. Also, like, and if you're using the great axes too, plus 9, like even in the base game with like that much strength, it wouldn't be 12 hits. It'd probably be like 10 as well. So it's like, I mean, it's like it's a big difference. Like it's obviously a lot stronger, but it's still like it's not. I don't think it's too overpowered to a point where I should like update and like not do the run with these. See how much faster the buildup is, though? Like, and it's not because that Deep Accursed is, like, resistant to poison. He's actually completely, like, super fucking weak to it. Yeah, I definitely should have bought more branches, dude. Kind of stupid. Hopefully I don't get hit because of it. Like, all I need it for is, like, to go up to the mage and have, like, a quicker route to her. But it honestly shouldn't even matter that much. Hopefully. Yeah, that should be the kill, right? Oh, just the kill. Beauty. Not really robot. Like, it would be after this part. It's fine. Hopefully. I don't like how far out he's walking. Like, we actually don't have that much more room. Yeah, because like I've been killing the mage and like a branch allows me to get like right up to the tree up there and then just sprint in. Considering we do all this shit, like, this run's still pretty fast. You know? Like, fighting 6 dancers. Big part is that we're skipping Cathedral. And, like, all the upgrade materials are just, like, in front of us. Like, just for progressing the game. Which is enormous, because normally you can't buy, now let's see what happens. Oh. Oh, there's a primordial. Give me another one. Okay, we have enough for a plus 11. Pog, dude. Well, that was also a counter hit, which are big in this. But yeah, it's a lot of damage. And keep in mind, you can get this 6 upgrade levels higher. We're actually getting a plus 11 in this, which is pretty cool. Maybe should have waited a bit longer. I'm gonna just upgrade right now. Plus 11, huh? Like, look how much more damage that is, too. Like, that's so much more AR we're getting. From, like, that's actually pretty sick, dude. Alright. I want to get it, man. Okay, fuck it. You can go to plus 15. But, like, it is really expensive, though. Like, In order for me to get to plus, like, so normally you get to plus 10, right? In order for me to get to plus 15, I would have to fight 7 more dancers. Yeah, or plus 10 for, yeah. Like the Scaler, Tight Knight, or I guess there's the dragon weapons too in this, too. Yeah, scales are twinkling. Nightmare Gundyr only gives one. I think, like, I haven't really tested the nightmares, but, like, Dancer gives 3. Like, I don't know if it's boss that gives more. But, yeah. So, yeah, that's why you need to do 7, because you need 20. But I'm not sure, like, maybe you can get more from, like, a different boss somewhere. I'm just not sure. Yeah, and that's, like, a lot more damage that you get. Yeah. No hit run. Cinder's mod.
I'm fucking Geno.
Fucking Geno, dude. Get the machine gun spell? Yeah, that'd be pretty funny. The ring, yeah, it's a calamity ring. Yeah, exactly. Robot got it. That's not bad, though. It was less than an hour 30. Barefist is actually, like, buffed to shit in this mod, Miklos. But I guess so are the bosses, right? I don't know. Yeah, so we'll do all bosses next. I'm not sure if we want to do it on this patch, though. Or, I don't know. I don't know, man.
GG easy.
Gamelli, thanks for the 100 bits, dude. Hey, so, well, this is like, the first no-hit run I've done in very long time, actually. Like, very long time, dude. Like, I don't even remember when the last, like, new no-hit run that I did was, like, really long time ago. So, I mean, it's kind of nice, but, like, I wouldn't say this was a very hard run. Nor did I, like, expect it to be. Especially when we have this much damage. Altan, what's up, dude? And Jonor, welcome back. Sparky Snow, how are you, dude? Terminosity, what's up? Yeah, thanks, guys. I mean, you know. DS1. Didn't I do Fist only after DS1? Or was that before? I think that was after. I don't remember. I don't know. It's been like a really long time. No, I've been slacking, dude. I've been slacking hard. Which, I mean, like, it's nice to get a break, I guess. But we'll get back into it. Maybe. This was cool, though. Like, it's kind of cool, like, doing new stuff. Even though we're still playing the exact same game and it's all the same bosses. I don't know. Like, and I always start up DS2, but then I just don't do it. I don't know. D9, what's up, man? Yeah, we'll do all boss in this. Like, again, I don't really expect it to take that long, but maybe there's, like, a bunch of different stuff. Like, I think we'll stay on this patch, honestly. Like, I don't know. What do you guys think? I'm not sure what to do. Okay, well, maybe go for it right now. Nah, I'm not gonna do that. I honestly don't really like doing that. Update when it's there. Well, the problem with that is, like, any given day, like, whatever I'm using could just be completely nerfed to shit, right? Like, one day I figure out, oh, like, I mean, for example, like, if it's on this, like, oh, the twin axes are, like, super good. And then, like, I'm going for the run, I get, like, a PB or something, and then the next day, it's like, oh, they're nerfed, and I have to update, and then a whole new route. Like, it's not, like, that's not really a good thing to do. Twin blades aren't really that good in this. Like, they're fine, but they're not like the twin axes. Like, the twin axes just, for some reason, have, like, really high damage. Yeah. Hey, did I finally get the no death challenge? Give me the no death challenge, lady. Hey. I don't know what that does. Yeah. Max HP, FP, stamina. Oh!